That is the feeling you get when you get clean water, right? Because water is not just, it's not just part of you, it's not just part of human being, but rather it's medicine to the soul. It's able to feed the soul, it's able to cure a human being of several diseases. And likewise, as it can cure you from several diseases, it can also lead to, it can also cause several diseases if this water is not in good quality and if it is being rendered to the people. I stand here today to actually make a pledge to the Cameroon government to be able to leave water in the hands of the public, like in the days of old. Because when basically do the comparisons of what happened in the days of old and the present days where water is now being privatized, we see that there are big lapses, right? We don't only get the lapses in the aspects of the distribution, in the access of quality drinking water. We also get the lapses in the management system. Now, this is what private sectors do in our country and in the world at large. The private sector is not a non-profit making organization. It's basically out to make profit. So if you carry social amenities and put in the hands of the private sector, it means in essence, you are generally killing the social community. You are generally killing everybody who's supposed to benefit from that social amenity. Because social amenities were made available by the government to be able to make sure that everyone in the community, irrespective of your level of, irrespective of whether you are fit to get that particular service, you should be able to have accessibility to that service. Water is not something that we are supposed to give into the hands of a private institution, basically because they will use it for their profit-making stuff. And because we don't want that, they should be using social amenities for profit-making. Basically, we are advocating for the fact that water should be left in the hands of the public. Now, this is what has happened in the past years. Before the privatization of water, in the yesteryears, we used to have good water services, good water quality. Water was being given to so many people in our communities, and the government was able to reach to about 74% of the total population in Cameroon. Not just the population in the urban areas, but also the population in the rural areas. Meaning everybody right in the suburbs was able to get a taste of not just good drinking water, but quality drinking water. I take you back now in the days when we come to privatization. Go just to places like Njumbi, go to places like Bangaye, before you could get quality good drinking water. I recently did an agricultural project in Banga, and by the time I came back, I almost died of dysentery. Why? Because the quality of the water which we were able to drink in Banga was not even up to a normal, it was not even up to normal water that we carry from the tap. It was not even up to good quality water that we carry from the tap. Nowadays, you can testify even in your house, the water you carry, you see that normally the characteristics of good drinking water, well, it has to be clean, it has to be clean, it has to be clear of color, it has to be free of smell. But most of us carry water in our house today from our taps, which actually has color. Why? Because of privatization. They don't care about whether this water is of good quality. What they care about is the profits they are making from the distribution of this water. They don't care about the welfare of the human being. They don't care about the welfare of the society. And this is what the government did in the yesteryears when the water was in the hands of the public. Water is a very, very delicate feature. It's something which actually, if we actually use it as a means to joke with human beings, then we are going to lose a lot of lives. Cameroon wants to emerge, right? Cameroon wants to grow, not just digitally. Cameroon also wants to grow in so many several sectors. But I think that if Cameroonians can prioritize the health of Cameroonians, then that is how we are going to grow, because we need Cameroonians to be able to grow Cameroon to the level that we want Cameroon to get to. Water is essential not just for health issues, but also in sectors like agriculture, which is a major sector in our economy today, which will actually lead us to what we call the emergence of Cameroon. And if we don't use good quality water to produce the products we are producing in the agricultural sector, then it means even rise to the extent of food. People are going to eat food which is contaminated by the effects of this water which we are also going to drink. So imagine you eating contaminated food and drinking contaminated water. What happens to that human being? It becomes a contaminated human being. What happens to our country? What happens to the economy of our country? It's actually running down within the mud. And that is not what we want for our country also. And that's why we are basically standing here today to be able to pledge, not just as an individual, but as a forum. That's why there are so many people there. It is just to tell us that this particular issue is not in the hands of one person. It's not in the hands of a single individual. And even if the government takes it as a personal project, it is the government. The government is not just one person. The government is the entire nation. The government is actually you and I sit here. So basically, it's in the hands of everybody, and it is all of us our responsibility to make sure that water is being affordable and is available for everybody in the community, be it in the local communities, be it in the urban communities, and it should not just be available, but also it should be available in good quantity and in good quality. Thank you very much.